man, this coffee's good. I probably should have paid more attention to lesson 24 on curbing addictions. Welcome to lesson 25, 15 fun and creative inexpensive dates and activities. My name is Corey Bryan. I'm a former Air Force pilot and currently a stay-at-home mom. I graduated from the Air Force Academy in 2004, ready for war, and I like to give a shout out to my ladies in the PPC. Besides accepting Christ into my life, the two most significant things are marrying my husband in 2007 and having my son in 2011. For the first 5 years of our marriage, we were dinks, dual income with no kids, and now we're on a single income with a son. So we have to budget and be more creative with our ideas. My first idea is just go hiking or walking and enjoy the outdoors. I like to Google good hikes in your area. Usually you can find ratings, reviews, and sometimes even pictures of the hike and be able to find out the difficulty levels. You can go all the way from flat to something extreme like doing the incline in Manitou Springs in Colorado. My second idea, different variations of dinner in a movie or a show. You can watch home videos with each other and laugh at each other. You can go to Hulu.com or any major network and watch your favorite TV series online for free. You can also go to Redbox and rent a DVD for a dollar for the night. You can go to your local grocery store and make your own pizza, or you can pick up a frozen pizza, usually about $5 to $7. Pop it in the oven 15 minutes and it's ready. My third idea is write down a to-do list with your sweetie and knock something out every weekend. When my husband and I were dating, we had our top 10 items. Two of them were watching the sunset and watching the sunrise. We were pretty good about watching the sunset, but the sunrise we weren't very good at. So maybe now that we have our son, we'll get a few more sunrises in. My fourth thing is train for an event together. You can go to runninginTheUSA.com and look at events in your state. This may not be for everyone though, I understand that. But my husband and I love to do that kind of stuff. We've done bike races, trail races, half marathons, triathlons, and we have a lot of good memories. One I can think of is when my husband and I did a bike race. He had to stop at an aid station to cut his shorts apart because he was getting his circulation cut off, which is pretty funny. And we laugh about that all the time. My fifth idea is high school sporting events. And I have some friends that really get into this. They wear the shirts, they cheer louder than anybody in the crowd. It's also a great way to get involved in your community. My sixth idea, picnic anywhere. A park down the street or find a lake or a pond. When I'm visiting my parents in Colorado, I like to go down to Palmer Lake and we walk the Santa Fe Trail, we pack a picnic, and then I throw the stick for my dogs in the water and they love doing that, so. Number seven, card games or board games. It's fun for friends and family. My husband and I love to play dominoes with our friends, and I know we sound like old souls, but sometimes we are. Number eight, volunteering together. And ladies, let me tell you, if your guy doesn't want to do this, that might be a red flag right there. I wish I did this more often because everywhere you turn, there's opportunities to volunteer, especially around the holidays, and it really feels good to make someone's day. My ninth idea, projects around the house, painting, building something, gardening, and then sit back, have a drink, and ooh and ah at a job well done. When I was 9 months pregnant, my husband and I painted the inside of our garage and we had a lot of fun. We bumped the music and I took breaks when I needed to. Number 10, go house hunting for your dream home. Check your local papers or drive around on the weekends for open houses. You can even dress the part and act like you're gonna buy the home. My 11th idea is go thrifting. Take a trip to your local thrift store or Goodwill or drive around on the weekends and find a garage sale in your area. You can make a challenge, who can find the most unique item, and you'll get a kick out of that. Number 12, turn your house into a spa. Set up a massage table, candles, music. My husband and I would put a white sheet over our futon and really make it authentic. When I was little, I used to give my parents coupon gifts. One free car wash, redeemable anytime. But funny, they never seem to redeem it. Anyways, you can do this with your spouse. Give them an hour free massage, redeemable anytime. I know my husband will really like that one, but I know I will, so. Number 13. Check out your local zoo. In Abilene, Texas, a year membership for two people is $30 for the entire year. So if you go enough, you're gonna get your money's worth. Or you can go online, check coupons. A lot of times you can get a buy one, get one free. 14, bookstore date. Share your favorite magazine articles with one another or maybe a favorite paragraph from your book. You'll get insight to one another and what your interests are. My 15th idea, visit your state and national parks. There's different levels of this trip. You can trade your entire Maui vacation, which would be really expensive, for a cheap road trip to California to visit Yosemite. My husband and I did that last year, and I highly recommend it. It was awesome. You can also do a weekend trip within your state. We drive to Fredericksburg, Texas, which is about 2.5 hours, and we have a fun little weekend there. Or you can do a day trip. Abilene State Park is about 15 minutes from us. We take our dogs down there and run around the lake. You can go to www.nps.gov for fee-free days, and you can get into the park for absolutely free. Or do what my husband and I do. We like to support the parks, so we buy a year pass, which is $60, and it gets an entire carload of people in. And we go enough that, again, we get our money's worth. Also, they just started giving free year passes for all national parks to military members, and that's an $80 value. So if you're in the military, go ahead and get your free pass. And a bonus splurge date. You'll have to save up for this, and it's typically about $20 per person. But if you've got an indoor rock climbing gym in your area, I suggest go do it. It's a lot of fun. I love going to City Rock in downtown Colorado Springs. They have an amazing facility. And now for your debt-free squad challenge of the week. Be creative and come up with your own inexpensive or free date. Leave a comment below. My husband and I would love to try your idea. Tune in next week for Lesson 26 when Jeff will be talking about big ticket items. Do you really need it? Good luck with your debt-free journey.